Hi, I'm Stephen Feuerstein, and I write practically perfect PLSQL. Hey everybody, it's Stephen Feuerstein, the coding therapist, here with a segment in my series of coding therapy for software professionals. And the topic of this session today, please relax on the couch, is game therapy. How you can use games to strengthen and entertain your brain. So obviously, writing software is serious, hard work, right? Not really. It's not all that hard as work goes. But anyway, we take it pretty seriously. We care a lot about what we're doing, et cetera, et cetera. And that can sort of like grind you down all day long. So I think it's good to take a lot of breaks, and at least at some of those breaks, play some games. Games can be very helpful in the learning process as well as giving you a chance to just step away from the pressure of the work. And part of the reason that people like to play games is they like to compete and they like to solve problems. I think humans are really driven around problem solving in general, and programmers in particular really like to solve problems because that's what writing programs is really all about. So I encourage you to play games. Now, I also encourage you to pick carefully what sort of game you play. For example, you could say, I'm going to play solitaire. Now, solitaire is a fine game, I suppose, but it doesn't really give you a whole lot of brain strengthening going on in terms of playing solitaire. I'm going to offer you a few different games that I think can make a significant difference in how well you are able to write your software. First up, Mastermind. So Mastermind is a game of deductive logic that was created by an Israeli statistician 20, 30 years ago, and you can find it online in all sorts of different places. Please feel free to find your own, and in fact, best of all is, don't find a version online, go ahead and get one of those little plastic boxes that Mastermind usually comes in, and you play with pegs. So in the real world, you can play Mastermind. Always better to escape from your computer whenever possible. One of my mottos. The reason I think that Mastermind is such a great game for you to play is, number one, it just strengthens your deductive logic skills. And deductive logic is absolutely critical in general when you're trying to think logically. And when you're trying to write software, because software is built on, first and foremost, symbolic deductive logic. Okay, so it's important that way, if you can use Mastermind to make you better at using your deductive logic skills. But the other reason I really like Mastermind is that the process by which you solve the Mastermind puzzle is really pretty much the same process that you use to debug software. And I believe that the better you get at Mastermind, the better you will be at debugging software and debugging it more quickly. And if you're like me, the worst part of writing software is having to debug it. I mean, couldn't I just write my code and get somebody else to get rid of the bugs for me? That'd be really nice. But in general, we're kind of stuck with our own code and we've got to fix it ourselves. So if we can do it faster and better, that'd be really cool. And you can do that with Mastermind. So hopefully you can see the parallels between debugging code and playing Mastermind, and that will encourage you to play the game. Also, the bottom line is that the more you play this game, the better you will get at deductive logic. And as your brain is able to spin through choices and understand the logical consequences of certain things that appear before you, you'll be able to apply that same adeptness, that same quickness, to the process of debugging code. So, Mastermind, great game, great for everybody who want to think better logically, and especially fantastic for software developers. All right. Let's take a look at the next game that I have in mind, which is called Set. Set is a game that involves a lot of pattern analysis and resolution of those patterns. And the reason I like Set is not only that it's a really simple, elegant, powerful game that's not only great for us, but especially great for our children. I encourage you to buy the card game and play it with your kids. I'll show you where in just a moment. But I think Set is a great game for software developers because it helps us identify common patterns. And pattern analysis is not only fundamental to the way our brains work in the world, but really fundamental to writing great code. I'm sure you've run into situations where people have clearly copied and pasted code. That's a repetition, that's a pattern. And you want to get rid of those patterns. Sometimes they're obvious, sometimes less obvious. And also, you want to identify broad patterns in the way that you write your code so that you can associate patterns with solutions. And the next time you see the same pattern, you say, oh, I understand that pattern. I want to loop through rows and then do an update statement. My solution is a for all statement, which will give me great performance and allow me to write the code relatively simply and quickly. As you tune up your brain to get better at identifying patterns, you can both get rid of those patterns proactively by reusing code. You can also identify when code is similar. The old feeling of deja vu code. Oh, I'm looking at this program and I swear I've seen something like this before last week in some package or other. When you start to pick up those patterns more and more, you can resolve the redundancy into either a dynamic SQL solution or a reusable code solution, depending on what's appropriate. And the more you do that, the more you reduce your code volume, the more maintainable and accessible your code is over the years to come. So that's the game of set. One more game, and that's the PLSQL Challenge. So this is my game, I must confess. I built a website called the PLSQL Challenge, plsqlchallenge.com. And it's a combination of gaming and technology. Very explicitly, you take quizzes on various technologies like SQL, PLSQL, logic. We actually offered a series of mastermind-like puzzles for a while. And database design, and probably others to come. So here's the PLSQL Challenge website. Once you register, you can take a quiz. Take your pick from all the different quizzes we have out there. So for example, I'm going to take the PLSQL Challenge quiz. So now we're going to take the PLSQL Challenge quiz. I'll click on my quiz icon. There's my quiz. So it asks me a question. I give them my choices. And now what I do as a player is generally not open up an editor and type some code and try things out. What I'm going to do is logically test my knowledge of these languages to read the code and figure out what's going to happen, which can be quite a challenging thing to do. We've had thousands of players over the years. People have been very addicted to playing the quiz. We used to actually offer a daily quiz, and we had 500 people a day playing the quiz. It's a great way to test your knowledge and burn it in, because it's active rather than passive. You're not reading a book. You're not watching a video like this. You're actually testing your knowledge against that quiz and against other players. You can compete, be ranked, etc. So I encourage you to check out the PLSQL Challenge as well. Okay, so to sum up, yes, you can just grind away all day long on your computer doing your hard, serious work. You can also say, you know what? I'm going to do that, but I'm going to make sure I take some breaks and freshen up my brain and have a little fun at the same time. And if you pick these games, Mastermind, Set, PLSQL Challenge, as you play those games, you will get better and better at your craft. And I do encourage you to go to your manager and actually ask for permission to play these games. You don't want them to like come across you playing a card game online and have him or her, you know, being irritated with you. In fact, a number of my students over the years have actually gone back to their managers and convinced them to hold competitions internally so that everybody plays Set every day, the daily quiz, and whoever solves the daily set of six, finds the six sets fastest, wins, whatever that means. So there are managers who are ready to understand the value of these kinds of games, who are ready to let you do it on company time. I wouldn't be afraid to ask. You can even do play set as a team, like on a Friday afternoon over pizza. Whatever the case may be, the point is that there are ways that you can sharpen your brain, make yourselves better programmers, and have fun at the same time. Wow, that's a great round of therapy. Thanks for joining me in my coding therapy session, and check out all my other therapy sessions as well. Take care and happy coding.